Harry. Oh. When in Rome, do as the Romans do. Hey, Mr. President.
How things are going with Haig?
So far, it's smooth sailing. I found an expert on China from France. I'm going to bring him to Washington, D.C.
Oh. Who is he? What's his name?
His name is Andre Mauro. His anti-memoirs encompasses a lot about Mao and Joe. Since the 30s, he's maintained contact on and off with them. He even went to China as France's Minister of Culture.
Oh, where is he? Bring him to me.
Of course.
Please, allow me to introduce André Mauro. He's the famous French writer.
Nice to meet you, Mr. President.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Mauro. Please, have a seat. Such a pleasure. Mr. Mauro, I heard a lot about you.
You're a China expert, so can you give me a crash course of my upcoming visit to China?
I'm really flattered, Mr. President. What do you want to know? My answers may not always be correct.
Have you met Mao?
I have. An extraordinary man.
You wouldn't have expected that Mao accept to receive a US president a couple of years ago, would you?
Came at no surprise to me. General de Gaulle had always been wishing to visit China and have talks with Mao. It's a pity he didn't make it.
And how do you believe in Chinese faith in communism?
I think the Chinese have no faith in whatsoever ideology. They believe in China first and foremost.
And what's your impressions about Mao?
An extraordinary man, indeed. You are sure you get a feel of Oriental mysticism around him.
Like many great men, I presume, such as Lincoln.
Yeah.
5 years ago, when I met Mao,
one of his biggest concerns was the ability of Americans or Russians to ruin China's industrial heartland with merely 10 nuclear bombs and set China back 50 years.
Mao told me that if he had 6 nuclear bombs in his hand, nobody dared bomb his cities.
If he had 6 nuclear bombs in his hands.
What does he mean?
I have no clue. He also stressed would never ever drop nuclear bombs on China.
Really?
Yes. Not all his words were understandable to me. I just report to you what he had said. You know, more often than not, it is those words that are not easy to understand that matter most.
Indeed.
Mr. Mauro, but really a pleasure to meet you. You are the Chinese experts. Really, thank you very much for your visit.
Mr. President, what you are set out to do is the most important thing in this century. I cannot but recall all those adventurers in the 16th century who set sail for a specific destination but ended up in a totally different place.
I will be the first sitting US president setting foot in the Chinese soil. It's just like an expedition to the moon.
I'm not General de Gaulle, but I know what he would say in this moment.
What?
He would say, all those who understand
what you are doing
will feel indebted to you.
Thank you very much for the visit, Mr. Mauro. It was a great pleasure.
My pleasure, Mr. President. Dr. Kissinger.
Mr. Mauro, please.
George, we need a corps commander, not a casualty.
Give him each a medal.
<笑>仔细看巴顿将军呢？这不是尼克松要来吗？补补课呀！哎，艾琳啊！
我让你给我找的书找到了吧？找到了，这个呀是目前出版的几本尼克松传记，还有呢，他本人写的《六四危机》。你对尼克松这个人怎么看呢？他这个人吧，很富有冒险精神，一直以来呢，他都是以反共立场名声大噪的。 但这回却要扭转20年来美国的外交政策，主动来中国。在他的政治生涯当中，遇到过不少挫折，但他从来没有认过输。I'll
deliver it.
这点倒是跟我很像。Rommel
and his tank and me and mine. We'd stop about 20 paces, we'd get out and shake hands, and we'd button up and we'd do battle, just the two of us.
我挺喜欢尼克松这个人。还有一件事，尼克松在他就任之后，选了三位他所仰慕的前任总统肖像挂在白宫里头，一位是艾森豪威尔，另一位是老罗斯福，这二位呢都是共和党人士，另一位是民主党人威尔逊。这很有意思。
尤其是这个威尔逊，这是一个才智过人的思想家。艾琳，现在外界对于尼克松访华是什么态度啊？说法很多的，那其中最尖锐的一个评论，说尼克松是打着白旗来的。
哎，看来啊，我要给尼克松解解围呀！Rommel, you magnificent bastard! I read your book.
，有句话，我想当面跟你说。什么悄悄话，还要当面说呀？尼克松总统马上就要来访问，我知道你肩上的担子很重，但是恩来，你毕竟已经是70多岁的人了，不再是20-30年前的你，所以啊，现在有些事情。 能让别人去做的，就不要总是事无巨细、举轻若重，啊？
累，我倒不怕，怕的是心累呀。发生了什么事吗？有些人呐，做的思想还是很严重，就连。
为尼克松访华准备的美国乐曲，也被有些人指责为美帝国主义唱赞歌。恩来，你就别再为这些事儿烦心了。你做的这些事情啊，都是为了国家，为了人民，丝毫没有为自己。无论过去多少年，历史自有公论。 人民自有公论。
我是周恩来。
我前几天去医院看他，他还说手术很成功，很乐观呢。这怎么突然就没了？
总理，是我们的医疗工作没有做好，我没有尽到责任。
不怪你们，是我没有保护好陈毅老总啊。这些年外交方面的工作让他费尽了心血呀。
那陈老总的后事，
我马上报告毛主席。
主席，
哦，恩来来了，
我有两件事情要向您汇报一下。
什么事？说吧。
第一件事情就是关于尼克松访华的，我和黑格将军一再磋商，经过尼克松亲自拍板，在尼克松访华期间的决定。使用我方的飞机和汽车。
这在美国可能是破天荒的头一次啊。
关于美方媒体记者随行采访的事情，现在有2000多份记者的申请函涌向了白宫。我们给他的限额是800人，他们希望能够再扩大一些。
可以考虑放宽一些。尼克松是想通过媒体告诉全世界，他的中国之行是伟大的明智之举嘛。
还有尼克松要访问的北京、上海、杭州，有好多打倒美帝国主义的标语，是不是在他来之前要撤掉啊？
不用拿掉，实事求是嘛。这是我们中国老百姓对美帝国主义的态度，不一定是对他尼克松的嘛。
还有一件事情，就是关于陈老总的追悼会，什么时间召开，什么人参加，规模搞多大？
外交部报了一个请示件，我看就按他们的意见办吧。陈毅的最后职务是副总理兼外交部长，可以安排外交部多去一些人，还有军队 也可以去一些人。他毕竟是元帅嘛。
老总的指导会员，他们通知你了吗？
没有啊。通知你了吗？
明天下午1点在外交部门口，部里面派辆大轿车去八宝山。
一辆大轿车，一辆大轿车，那才能坐多少人啊？他们搞错了吧？谁不让我去的？我去找他们。
别去，据我所知，是老总的追悼会。
你管他，对我就像父亲一样。我一个做女儿的去送送他，我有错吗？谁不知道？谁不知道他是赫赫有名的开国大元帅呀？他为了新中国，他南征北战，出生入死。他在外交部15年，他兢兢业业，他跟着周总理去了那么多的国家，结交了那么多的朋友。为新中国的外交事业做出了多少奋斗，这是全世界人民都有目共睹的。子枫，明天的追悼会，无论如何我都一定要去。坐你们的大轿车，我自己骑车去。
明天我陪你骑车去。
吃饭呀，这早饭就没吃，再这么下去身体怎么受得了呀？
现在几点了？
1:30了。 主席，要不您就稍微吃点吧。这饭菜都凉了，我再去给您热热。备车。
要去参加陈毅同志追悼会。主席，什么？毛主席要出席陈毅同志的追悼会？好，好，我立刻安排。快，毛主席要参加陈毅同志的追悼会。 追悼会的规格要提高，你马上通知在京的政治局委员和部委，务必出席陈毅同志的追悼会。还有，通知宋庆龄副主席、全国人大、政协、国防委员会的同志，凡是邀请参加陈毅同志追悼会的，都参加。是。
毛昭大使吧，我是周恩来，请你转告西汉努克亲王，如果他愿意，请他出席陈毅同志的追悼会，我们将有国家领导人出席。
赵倩，
主席，您怎么也来了？我也来悼念陈毅同志。 陈毅是个好同志啊！我们从井冈山的时候就在一起了。他对中国革命和世界革命做出过贡献，立了功啊！
谢谢主席。
朱老总来了，
老总。
哦，主席啊。 老总啊，你怎么来的？这么早？主席是最早来参加追悼会的。张杰，老总，张杰，主席，西哈努克殿下，你和陈毅同志打交道比较多。
陈毅元帅。
永远是柬埔寨人民的好朋友，我们永远感激他，尊敬他。陈毅同志，值得尊重。他这个元帅去当外交部长，始终是表里如一，心直口快。主席，您坐一会儿就回去吧。
不。
小草，没想到毛主席也参加了陈老总的追悼会啊！可惜啊，陈老总走得太早了。是啊，恩来，你也要注意自己的身体。来，坐这儿，我有件事儿要问问你。
什么事啊，
恩来？今天吴阶平院长告诉我说，
你最近这段时间尿血的情况已经很严重了，是这样吗？
不要听大夫夸大其词。最近一段时间比较忙，着急上火，尿有些浑浊，不是什么大事啊。本来你要知道，你的身体不是你自己的。
也是党和人民的，小张。正因为我把自己交给了党和人民，所以我不能放弃工作。最近，尼克松要来访华，内政外交前途万绪，我走不开呀。
Hey, my dear, how was your day?
Hey, it was fantastic. By the way, Daddy, are you going to China tomorrow?
Yes. You know the one who landed on the moon on the Apollo aircraft, left a sentence on a monument there. We came in peace for all mankind. 2 days, it applies to me as well. For the welfare of the humankind, I'm going to China, a secret and ancient world from far away.
I wish I could go with your father. Could you take me along, please?
Not this time, my dear. But I believe you will have the opportunity to go there once the US and China improve their relations.
So it means I should stay here for a while.
You stay here for a while, and you will be a good girl, I'm sure. And I will travel for about 15 days.
Oh, so long.
Ah, we're going to Guam, then Shanghai, then Beijing. Okay?
So, okay.
Hey, 总理。
1972年2月21日，美国总统尼克松乘坐专机“空军一号”从华盛顿机场起飞，开始了世人瞩目的破冰之旅。
When will we arrive in Beijing?
It'll be 11:30 Beijing time. Now this is a special arrangement by Zhou Enlai. It will be prime time for Americans who'll be watching TV at night. Our reporters are ready. They will broadcast your actions live via satellite to the whole world once you get off the plane.
I heard the rumor that former Secretary of State John Dulles refused to take hand with Zhou Enlai during the Geneva's conference in 1954. He also ordered the entire American delegation to not shake hands with a member of the Chinese delegation. It badly hurt Joe. Now I'm in China. I'm gonna whip off all this unpleasantness hampering the China-US relation. So when we get off the plane, all our men should stay in the cabin. They shall not go with me. I've made some arrangements, sir, to make sure nothing goes wrong.
Of course.
When we take off, you stay at the cabin door, stopping anyone from following us.
Yes, sir.
I suddenly feel like an adventurer, engaged in a journey of philosophical discovery, like the ancient geographic discovery, whose future is uncertain, destination unknown, just like an adventurer. Harry, do you believe the Chinese will overcome their old decades of hostility towards America and make my trip successful?
Please, rest assured, Mr. President, if we've arranged every detail for the Chinese, the American public, they will be inspired by your courage and your originality.
And will I meet Mao Zedong in person?
I think that you will, sir.
Well, they haven't given a reply yet. If we return without meeting with Mao Zedong, my visit in China will be a total failure and embarrass the American government.
That should not happen, sir. If, by chance, you cannot arrange a meeting for the Mao, I believe that it will only be construed that he has a serious medical condition.
Well, I'm taking a serious gamble now. God bless me, and God bless America.
主席，醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！醒了！
刚刚总理已经来过电话了，中午11点的时候尼克松总统就到了，现在已经入住钓鱼台国宾馆了。
啊，告诉恩来，我现在就要见尼克松总统。
主席，可是您的身体现在不适合接见外宾啊。
哎，我说了，让他们现在就来。
Such an exhausting trip, huh?
Oh, but this trip to China is truly wonderful.
Yes, it is.
Oh, Henry, what a surprise.
I have urgent business, Mr. President.
Of course, come in.
Henry, what's going on? Joel has just informed us that Chairman Mao wants to meet right now. Fantastic. Where are we going to meet? In their great hall of people? Well, due to the Chairman Mao's health condition, he's now only accepting foreign heads of state at his private residence in Zhongnanhai. A meeting between the Chinese and U.S. heads of state is a real solemn event. How could it be held in a bedroom? Besides, we just arrived in Beijing. I was about to have a bath to refresh me after a long trip. Don't you think it's a little impolite to make such a moment? Mr. President, the historical significance of a meeting for Chairman Mao that far outweighs any etiquette issues. Would you not agree? Now, Joe is waiting for us. Mr. President, I'm afraid that if we let this opportunity slip through our fingers, you may not get another chance to meet with Chairman Mao during this visit.
Just the two of us?
Joe is waiting now, and the car is already downstairs.
Well, let's go.
Let's go.
Thank you, my dear.
Of course.
主席，您现在的身体状况很不适合接待外宾。
你们是怕马克思突然把我叫走了？
如果您执意要接见尼克松，时间最好控制在15分钟之内。
主
席。主席，尼克松的车队已经到了中南海了。
哦。哎。
快把主席的鞋拿来。
哎，你们呢，都别跟着我啊。
哎，主席，换鞋。
Henry, did you come to that place during your last visit?
No, sir, but I can feel a mysterious atmosphere within these red walls.
Henry, what do you think I should talk with Mao and see?
It's very hard to say, sir. They say that Mao has a very peculiar sense of humor. He's the complete opposite of Joe, who's considered very stern.
Yes, and feels strangely even nervous.
I didn't even have such a feeling when I delivered my inaugural speech.
It's a bit like landing on the moon, eh, sir? Meeting Mao is like landing on the moon.
Chairman Mao, such a pleasure to meet you.
非常高兴见到你。
你就是那个有名的博士基辛格。
好 ，Chairman Mao, I was unable to meet you during my first two trips. I'm so happy I've had a chance to meet with you now.
终于见到你了。
来，坐吧。
我心不走过变幻的风雨里，你越发为我，唯有那么一天，万秋同此两人，余生。 谁先想着我们？